Student, welcome to my class of computer science for class 11th. In this video, student, we are going to understand some operation of list data type, in which we have covered today what is insertion sort. So let's begin. So first of all, we have to understand what is the algorithm, what are the steps, and what is insertion sort. So to do, we have to open our study material. Here we are talking about insertion sort. So student, insertion sort actually a simple sorting algorithm. As you know, algorithm is a step by step solution for a particular problem. So we are talking the same. So that help us and works to similar way that sort, that playing card in your hands, or array, I mean to say list, in virtually split into a sorted order or unsorted part. And value from the unsorted part are like picked and placed and correct position in the sorting part. Okay, so student, like bubble sort, insertion sort is the same mechanism, I am to say, doing the same task but differently. So first of all, we are going to understand its algorithm. As I told you, algorithm is a step by step solution for a particular problem. So let us understand what are the steps of algorithm to sort an algorithm. Suppose that we have n size of list in a order way. So how to ascend it? I mean to say how to make it short. So first step is that iterate from list array from 1 to array n over n, definitely list or array. Okay, student. So first of all, we have to iterate. It means to say traverse. We have to traverse from first index position to n index position over a list or array. In the term of Java or C, C++, the list is known as array. So we are talking about Python, so we can consider here is a list. Second step says that compare the current element to its, that is, processors. Okay, so whatever the current element we have, suppose that we can say that array of 1 we have, it is current element, we have to compare its predecessors. Third step, I am to say step number third, if the key element is smaller than a predecessors, I am to say it's the neighboring, compare it to element before. Okay, so here a particular element, I am to say our key element is definitely small, okay, then it's a relative particular elements, we have to compare two elements before element and move together element in one position. Okay, so as we got this is lesser than the earlier one, so we have to exchange it also, I am to say, by swapping method, and make it space and swapped element also. So now we will do it again and again, so we will understand through the example. Suppose that we have this following type of values in our list, like 4, 3, 2, 10, 12, 1, 5, 6. So as I told you, student, we have to just compare the first element. So first element according to indexing, that is 3. So we will compare, first of all, it's a previous element. So we will see this particular third is lesser than 4. So we will swap it. Okay. And in next step, you can see that 4 will come to the third place and say element number 3. And third element will come to the fourth element place. So it means to say index value now 3 is 0, 4 is 1. And now whatever the particular index value, I am to say comparison, we will shift to next one and we will compare again this particular to third. So you can see, so it will exchange, I am to say swap by third. So 2 will come here, 3 here, 4 here, okay, and so on. So you can understand, we have swap it. So first term is I will be 1, I will be 2, I will be 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so according to the number of I mean to say outer loop, we can consider the comparison of key value. Okay, and we can see this list has come. So now we are going to compare this 10. So we will see which one is bigger. There is, I think 10 is bigger than previous element. There is no such element which is smaller than 10. I will say bigger than 10. So it will be let it be. In next step, 12 will be compared. So 12, we can see that everything is okay. I mean to say there is no bigger value as compared to the 12. Now we are come to the first. Okay. So this element will definitely check previous element, which will check the first element is definitely greater than this one. So it will be swapped to second number position, and then value will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 10 and 12. And then after that, we are going to compare 5. So here 5 will also compare first of all to 1, to 2, 3, 4. At this position, it can see, you can see that 5 is lesser than 10. So it will be changed the position of particular 5, okay, to the 10. So next value will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10 and 12. You can see the rest of element will be shifted to the next index value. Now 6 will compare to definitely particular 10. So it will be shifted to the next condition. Like you can see that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 10 and 12. If you'll talk about this particular example, so here another example, 12, 11, 13 and 5 and 6. You can see that we can consider outer loop is I, which starts always from 1. That is second element. Okay. So here the particular second element of the list, we can see that to compare to last four element array. So 11 will compare to 12. So this time what is going on? This time 11 will swap, okay, to the element of 12th position. I am to say index 0 will be contained by 11 and index 1 will contain by 12. So it will be look like this. Okay. Next time we are going to see I will be 2. So this time I will be 2 means 13 particular value of the element of the list. So 13 will compare to again definitely 12. Okay. And then after that it will see it is okay, let it be, because we can see 12 is definitely bigger value, smaller value as compared to 13 value or key value. Now I will be 3, then 5 will be as a key value. We can see that 5 will be key value. So here 5 will be compared to the first one value. So you can see that it will be exchanged and it will come first position, I am to say 0th index, and rest of element will be shifted to the rest of element like 11, 12, 13. After that I will be 4, 6th element will be compared. 6 will be compared to the definitely 5, so it is a smaller than that 11. So that meant 6 will be in the place of 11 and the rest of element will be shifted to the, that is, right side. So we are going to the programming part also. So in this programming part, what we are going to do, suppose that we have created a particular code, a program for implementing instruction sort. So first of all, we can consider here we have value like same that 12, 11, 13, 5 and 6 in a list. And we have just print out what was the before sorting the list. So once we have to just see the output, you can see the before sorting output 12, 10, and that is 11, 13, 5 and 6. This is unordered, I am to say mixed way, okay, or unsorted. And after that, here we are going to provide your logic. So first of all, we are doing I as outer loop. So for I in a range, it will be start from 1, not from 0, because as per according to algorithm of the instruction sort, I will be definitely 1. Okay, first value will be definitely 1, not the 0, because we have to compare to the back side. And the length of array, as you know, what is the length of array? Would this one thing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5 elements are there. So according to 5 element, it will run 1 to 4 only. So here we are going to store array of I every time as a key, because we are going to compare the key value to its previous value also. I am say previous element in a list also. So here what we have done, here we have created a while loop, that is j equals to I minus 1. Why? Because I is by default starting by 1. So I minus 1 will be, that is 0. So j will be definitely 0. And we will say in a while loop, this should be run, okay, when j bigger than definitely or equals to 0, and key if definitely smaller than array of j. So let us understand what is going to tell in this particular code. So here we are going to run, if the 0, I am to say j is definitely 0 or bigger than 0, and both condition true, key whatever the key we have opt from, suppose that 11 is lesser than array of j, okay. So if both condition is true, array of j means 12 this time, if both condition is true, then condition will be true and loop will be enter to the its body part. Now we can see array, that means to say this list arr and j plus 1, okay, whatever the j plus 1, because j plus 1 indicates I, okay. So here is I means first position, j of I will be array of j, okay, definitely the whatever the j, that means to say 12 will be stored to the definitely 11th condition, and j definitely minus of by 1, that means to say we are going to decrease the j. So in this time array of j plus will be definitely key, it means to say we have exchanged the 11 to 12 position, 12 to 11th position, okay student. So here we have learned this particular whole code actually swapping the particular element to the position and rest of element to the right side. You can see that move ahead of the array 0 to I minus 1 that are greater than key and one position ahead, okay, whatever the position, all content I am to say element will be shifted to one position next indexing of their current position. So student, we are going to the same. So to do student, we have to open our Python IDLE. That is definitely GUI mode. And then I will open a new file. In this new particular file, I'll say a program simply. Python program for insertion short. Okay, here what I am going to do, suppose that I have a m list. So in m list I will place some value like suppose that 2 1, like suppose that 2 1 5 7 12 90, or we can say that 4500 or 67 or 0, okay. So what we are going to do, simply we will print first a message to user before sorting what is my m list, okay. M list is with comma m list, okay. So I have just to run it. So I will save it, insertion short. So simply you can see that before shorting m list is this, okay, that is 2 1 5 7 12 19 4567 and 0. So it will be better if I'll type here a header of my particular program. So I will say insertion short program, that will be look better. And then after that we have done the complete part of the particular m list condition. Now the logic part will begin from here. Logic part for insertion short, okay. So what we are going to do, first of all, we have to provide a traverse mechanism as per according to algorithm. So here I will take I variable
definitely in a range. Okay, in this I will start from 1 and I will count the length of m list by functionally. Okay, then after that I will say in this condition whatever our key value. So here my m list of I will be key value, every time it will change. And next one I will say variable j. Okay, variable j, why? Because I need to run this inner loop through the j variable. So here I minus 1 I will say whatever the current position of I, it will be from backside. Okay, and then I will say while, within while I will say if j is bigger than or 0, and because I want to have the both condition, key is definitely if slower m is lesser than m list of, here is m list of definitely, here is g. Okay, because according to g we are going to compare. Then the, if this condition is true, we will say m list of definitely j plus 1, because I'm talking about next step, that is I will be changed m list of definitely again j. Okay, student. So this means to say whatever the position of j, that means to say here is j is minus 1, so j, okay, it will be stored the value of previous value. Okay, it means to say the element will be shifted to the next step. This will say whatever the index value, it is after the index value, whatever, suppose the index value have 0, so it is 1. If it is 1, then it considered 2. Okay, so it means to say we are shifting the element to the next element and next index position by this particular command. Okay, next one command, so I will say j minus 1 because I am going to check the previous one also, and we will say out of the particular, this particular loop, here is my m list of definitely j plus 1 will be definitely here key. So what is going on, student? Here, look at here, it is simple and easy and quiet. So you can see we have traversed the loop through the index position 1 to the rest of n element, that means say n minus 1. Okay, so here we have just used that, and every time whatever the I variable, outer variable, it is considered as key variable. I am to say what we are going to compare, and here is j equals to I minus 1, whatever the I, it will be minus 1 means in this condition 2, I am to say 0 condition. And then this particular condition says that if j is bigger than or equal to 0 and key m list lesser than m list of j, then it will run. It means to say j should be bigger than 0 and or 0. Okay, index value it says, and this one says that if key element, that means to say here in condition 1, if is smaller than m list of j, j means 2. Okay, so then it will run, and what is going to do, it is going to say whatever the jth element, okay, it will be shifted to the next index position and j minus will be 1. Net last, the key value will be shifted to j plus 1. So here we have done, and at last I will say simple thing, print, within this print I will say after shorting m list is definitely, I will type the same, this means to say m list. Okay, we are just going to run it. Now you can see here I have misspelled, so here somewhere I have misspelled, student. I will just see whether it is done. Am I late? I have type here somewhere. So I'm going to just run it. You can see this is the output. You can see before the shorting is 2, 1, 5, 7, 12, 90, 4500, 67 and 0. After sorting, you can see that 0, 1, 2, 5, 7, 12, 67, 90 and 4500. So student, I hope student you have learned it. You will do this practical. Till then student, thank you and have a nice day, students.